We are going to discuss adrenal gland disorders. Adrenal glands are two in number and are located anterior to the upper poles of the kidney. The gland is pyramidal in shape on the right side, and left adrenal gland is more concentric in shape. That is maybe due to the liver compressing the adrenal gland on the right side. Size of an adrenal gland is almost like 5 cm. This is the cut section of an adrenal gland, which weighs about like 4 to 6 grams and is comprises of cortex and medulla. The cortex is more yellow and orange in color due to lipid content and further divided into 3 zones. Adrenal medulla comprises of less than 10% of the volume of the gland and is gray-white in color and comprises of more basically chromaffin cells and that secrete catecholamines. Adrenal cortex is further divided into 3 zones, glomerulosa, fasciculata, and reticularis, like GFR. Glomerulosa secretes like more secrete salt and mineralocorticoids, mainly aldosterones. Fasciculata is more sugar, like glucocorticoids and cortisol. And reticularis is with sex hormones like androgens and estrogens. So GFR like salt, sugar, and sex. This is the histologic picture of an adrenal gland, which shows adrenal cortex and medulla in 3 zones of adrenal cortex: zona glomerulosa, fasciculata, and reticularis. In zona glomerulosa, the cells are more discontinuous and there is a thin layer and it comprises of cells with less amount of cytoplasm. While in zona fasciculata, the cells, they have more lipid in content. They arrange in rows and columns. And in zona reticularis, the cells have more abundant eosinophilic cytoplasm and they have a pigment lipofuscin. Adrenal medulla comprises of cells, chromaffin cells with secrete catecholamines. So they are like associated with salt, sugar, sex, and stress. As you go deeper, it gets more sweet. Hyperadrenalism. Hyperadrenalism is a syndrome that is related to overproduction of one or more of the 3 basic adrenal cortical steroids, like hyperaldosteronism due to excessive amount of glucocorticoids, Cushing syndrome due to excessive secretion of cortisol, and is the most common of the 3. Adrenogenital syndrome, that is due to excessive secretion of androgens and estrogens from zona reticularis. Cushing syndrome occurs as it most commonly due to administration of excessive amount of glucocorticoids, most common cause. And it could be due to cortisol hypersecretion by adrenal adenoma, carcinoma, or nodular hyperplasia, or ectopic ACTH production by non-endocrine neoplasm. Or it could be due to primary hypothalamic pituitary disorders, which are associated with ACTH hypersecretion. Cushing syndrome clinically is characterized like the patient presents with adipose tissue redistribution, central obesity, and buffalo hump, distribution of fat on the back of the neck, accumulation of fat on the back of the neck, and moon faces. Atrophy of type 2 fibers result in decreased muscle mass and there is proximal muscle weakness. You also patient presents with like hirsutism, hypertension, hyperglycemia, glycosuria, and poor wound healing. and their abdominal striae due to catabolic effects on the collagen. Bone resorption and osteoporosis increases the risk of fractures and mental disturbances and depression. This picture shows typical moon faces of children with Cushing syndrome and the characteristic fat distribution like buffalo hump and purplish striae on the abdomen. Primary hyperaldosteronism, Cone syndrome, is characterized by autonomous aldosterone secretion and it leads to sodium retention and potassium excretion with resultant hypertension and hypokalemia. The renin angiotensin system is suppressed and thus plasma renin activity is low, and the causes, it could be like primary idiopathic hyperaldosteronism. It's the most common cause and the etiology is unknown. Primary hyperaldosteronism, the causes could be like, as we had discussed, 60% it's idiopathic. Then comes the adrenocortical neoplasms in 35% of the cases, like it could be solitary aldosterone secreting adenoma, Cone syndrome, or it could be like cortical hyperplasia, and it's familial, that is rare. Secondary hyperaldosteronism, that is due to aldosterone release that occurs through activation of renin angiotensin system. That could be due to decreased renal perfusion or in edema due to congestive heart failure, liver failure or kidney conditions like kidney end-stage renal disease, or it could be in pregnancy in which there is impaired or increased synthesis of angiotensinogen that results in increased production of aldosterone. Adrenogenital syndrome, that is characterized by virilization in females and feminization of precocious puberty in male. That is mainly due to cortical neoplasms and more likely due to cortical adrenocortical carcinoma, which secrete excessive amount of androgens, or it due to cortical hyperplasia. There is a condition called congenital cortical hyperplasia, that is an autosomal metabolic disorder that results in defective enzymes production involved in adrenal steroid synthesis. 21-hydroxylase deficiency is a condition which results in buildup of 17-hydroxyprogesterone due to defective conversion of progesterone to 11-deoxycorticosterone, and it accounts for 90% of congenital adrenal hyperplasia, and it depends on the nature of the mutation, and in which it can manifest in three different type of syndromes. This is the grass specimen which shows on the top left you can see normal adrenal gland, and the lower to that is an adenoma, like it's a circumscribed lesion that is arising from the adrenal cortex, and next to that there is also that it's a lobulated gray white adrenal adenoma or a carcinoma that you will most likely differentiate on the microscope. As we had discussed previously, in endocrine organs, the criteria for malignancy is metastasis, either capsular vascular invasion or either distant metastasis into lymph nodes. This is the grass specimen of adrenal cortical adenoma, which is well circumscribed and capsulated and yellow in color. This is the histologic picture of adrenal cortical adenoma, which shows these nests and cords and sheets of cells with abundant eosinophilic cytoplasm and round central nucleus and separated by these congested blood vessels. Adrenal insufficiency. Adrenal insufficiency can occur either acute or chronic primary loss of adrenal function or through secondary to diminish ACTH production. Primary acute, that is adrenal crisis, that is sudden increase in glucocorticoid requirements in patient with chronic insufficiency. Primary chronic, that is autoimmune disease, Addison's disease, and secondary that could be due to cause of any pituitary tumor or pituitary adenoma, and that results in adrenal insufficiency. Primary acute adrenal insufficiency could be due to rapid withdrawal of steroids or failure to increase the steroid dose in periods of stress. Massive adrenal hemorrhage. Waterhouse-Fredrickson syndrome is a rare syndrome, and it's characterized by overwhelming septicemic condition, clinic classically due to meningococcus. Could be due to Staph aureus or H influenza, and is characterized by hypovolemia and shock, DIC, with purpura, and there is massive adrenal hemorrhage and adrenal insufficiency. Treatment is antibiotics. Or in newborns with difficult delivery can present with acute primary adrenal insufficiency or with anticoagulant therapy, or in patients with poor surgical DIC, they can present with adrenal insufficiency. Primary chronic adrenocortical insufficiency, like 60 to 70% of Addison disease, is autoimmune. Infectious processes like fungal diseases, histoplasmosis, tuberculosis, or in patients of AIDS, they can present with primary chronic adrenocortical insufficiency. Metastasis. Adrenals are an amazingly preferred sites for early lung carcinoma metastasis or in breast carcinomas. Genetic disorders are rare, like it could be like congenital adrenal hypoplasia congenita, and it could be due to some X-linked disorders. In Addison's disease, primary chronic adrenocortical insufficiency, the patient presents with insidious onset of weakness, fatigue, lethargy, and with features of hyperkalemia, hyponatremia, and hypotension due to mineralocorticoid deficiency. And there is cutaneous hyperpigmentation, and the patient can progress to death and unless corticosteroid therapy is initiated. Secondary adrenocortical insufficiency occurs with any hypothalamic or pituitary disorder that leads to diminished ACTH production. It could be due to tumor, infection, or infarction of the gland, and that results in panhypopituitarism. There is absence of hyperpigmentation, and there will be no hypernatremia and hyperkalemia that are not features of secondary adrenocortical insufficiency. Adrenocortical neoplasms are adenomas of adrenal cortex or carcinomas of the adrenal cortex. This is the grass specimen of adrenocortical adenoma, which is well circumscribed, gray-brown in color and with homogeneous cut surface. In functioning adrenal cortical adenomas, the adjacent adrenal cortex is compressed, while in non-functioning tumors, the adrenal cortex is of normal thickness. This is another grass specimen showing adrenal cortex adenoma with gray-brown color. Foci of hemorrhage is well circumscribed and encapsulated. This is the histologic picture of adrenal cortical adenoma that resembles the normal cortical cells, which are arranged in sheets, cords, and nets, and comprises of round nucleus and eosinophilic cytoplasm. These are separated by these congested blood vessels. You can see nuclear ATPR, hemorrhage, and these endocrine neoplasms, as the criteria of malignancy is vascular capsular invasion or distant metastasis. This is the grass specimen of adrenocortical carcinoma. Look at, it's variegated and there are areas of hemorrhage. You can see cystic change and necrosis as well. So it's a variegated necrotic gray-brown mass. This is the microscopic picture of adrenal cortical carcinoma. You can see the cells are bizarre. They are pleomorphic. The abnormal mitosis can be seen. And these cells are arranged in sheets and with areas of necrosis. But the criteria for malignancy in adrenal cortical carcinoma is, I'm emphasizing again and again, is metastasis to distant organs or either capsular or vascular invasion.